Hello everyone, I'm Anita with Anita by Design, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a robe. Now, I made robes for my husband and my two sons for Christmas, and several of you have requested that I do a tutorial for the robe. So, let's get started. Okay, let's talk about the supplies that you're going to need. We will be using Simplicity 1562. Now, this pattern includes sizes for children, teens, and adults. So I want to draw your attention to the back of the envelope to make sure that when you go to purchase your fabrics, you're purchasing the correct yardage for whichever size or, you know, whoever you're sewing it for. In the first column, you have your yardages for children and teens. And I imagine smaller teens. And then in the second column here, you have the yardage for teens and adults. So just make sure when you're purchasing your fabric that you're following the yardage for whoever you're sewing the pattern for. Okay, so that's it. And then also you'll notice the recommendations for fabrics here, and they include flannel, cotton interlock, fleece, sweatshirt fleece, and velour. Now, you can follow the fabric suggestions on the back of the envelope if you choose. However, we are going into spring, so if you prefer to make a lightweight robe, then you can choose a different type of fabric. You can, maybe you want a nice soft silk robe. You can use a silk fabric or a lighter cotton or any type of lightweight fabric that you'd like to make your robe in. You are welcome to do that. So let's talk about my fabric choice. I'm going to use a fleece, and I chose an anti-peel fleece that I picked up from Joann's Fabrics, and I'll leave a link in the description box below if you'd like to, you know, choose this same one or another fleece from Joann's Fabrics. So that's what I will be using. Now let's talk about some of the supplies that you will need. Make sure that you follow the instruction. Actually, on the back of the envelope, the only thing they list for supplies is thread. You don't need a whole lot of other things, but your staples, I'm going to show you those things now. You're going to need your fabric scissors. You're also going to need your paper scissors for cutting your pattern pieces. You're going to need pattern weights. You're also going to need straight pins. Now, if you are using a thicker, lofty fabric and you don't use pattern weights, then it's fine to use your pins alone. However, if you do use pattern weights, you're going to need both. You're going to need your pattern weights and your straight pins, and I'll show you why later. You're going to need, or I suggest that you use a walking foot, because if you're using the thick, lofty fabric, the walking foot will really help you get over to sew over the thicker fabric. If you're using a lightweight fabric, then you can just use your regular standard foot, or you could use the standard foot for your lofty fabrics too if you don't have it. But if you do have a walking foot, I do recommend using that one. You're gonna need a seam gauge, because we're gonna be using that to take some measurements at the sewing machine. For those of you who will be sewing with lightweight fabrics, then you can use your tracing wheel and your tracing paper. You're also going to need, of course, a sewing machine needle, and I'm sewing with fleece, so I'm going to be using number 12. Make sure you choose a needle that coincides with the type of fabric that you're using. And then for finishing the seams on my robe, I'm going to use a double needle, and I'm going to straddle the seam with the double needle and then trim away the excess seam allowance. For those of you who are using a lighter weight fabric, you can just serge your ends, or if you choose, you can serge your seam allowances with the fleece or whichever type of thicker fabric you're going to use. You're going to need a coordinating thread for sewing your robe, and you're also going to need a contrasting thread. And the reason I'm having you to purchase a contrasting thread is for those of you who are sewing with a thicker fabric, a lofty fabric, it's difficult to make your transfers from your pattern tissue onto your fabric with a tracing wheel and tracing paper. So we're going to use tailor's tacks, and I'm going to show you guys how to do that. So you're going to need a contrasting thread, and I recommend a small pair of scissors or a pair of nippers if you have it. If you don't, you can use your regular scissors, but this makes it really easy to get in there and cut between the layers of fabric with your tailor's tacks. Now, for the thread that you will choose for your tailor's tack, I recommend a contrasting thread because you really need to be able to see that thread, because the thread is going to be your markings onto your fabric. So if you're using a light colored fabric, then use a darker thread, and vice versa. Use a lighter thread if you're using a darker fabric. Now, when you guys get ready to cut your pattern pieces, there are only 7 pieces for this pattern. However, 2 of those pieces are extension pieces. So we're going to be taping together two extensions onto 2 pattern pieces. And I'm going to show you guys how to do that right now. So grab piece number 1 and piece number 5. I'm going to show you with piece number 1, and then you'll be able to do piece number 5 on your own. So grab those 2 pieces and then grab the extensions 1A and 5A, and I'll show you how to pin the extensions onto the bottom of your pattern pieces. Okay, I have piece number 1 and piece 1A in front of me. And these are the pieces that we're going to tape together to make one full piece. And you're going to do the same thing with piece 5, or pieces 5 and 5A. So I want to draw your attention to the small circles at the top of the extension and the bottom of the, or piece number 1. You see little circles with crosses through them. And what you're going to do is you're going to take those symbols on the extension and match them to the symbols on the piece number 1. And just make sure you'll be able to see clearly. Make sure you line them up evenly and that all 4 of them are directly on top of each other. The circles on the extension are directly on top of piece number 1. Then you're going to take your tape, clear tape, and then you can just hold down that piece, making sure you don't shift it. Now, another thing you can do to ensure that you don't shift this before taping is you can put some pattern weights on top in between if you like, to make sure you don't shift. So make sure it's in the right place, and then go ahead and place a piece of tape on top. And you feel free to use however many pieces of tape you like for your comfort. I'm going to use 3. And after I tape on the front, I'm going to flip it over and tape on the back. And again, you can use however many pieces of tape you'd like. So now we have one full piece for number 1, which is the front and under collar for the robe. Okay, now you will do that to piece number 5, and then grab your fabric, go ahead and lay out your pieces, and cut out all of the pieces that you need. But before removing your fabric from the pieces that have markings to transfer onto your fabric, I want you to meet me back here, and I'm going to show you guys how to do the tailor's tacks. Okay, so grab your pieces and meet me back here. Okay, we have all of our fabric pieces cut. We have piece number 1 and piece number 5 with the pattern tissue still attached, and any other pieces, your sleeve, any other pieces that have markings that need to be transferred over to your fabric, leave the pattern attached, and you're going to pin. Now, if you're using pattern weights, you're going to use the pins also. And what you're going to do is you're going to pin wherever there is a transfer mark, the little circles. You're going to go ahead and add a pin there. I added 2 pins, 1 on each side of the circle. You can do that, or you can just use 1 pin. So we have the 2 circles here at the armhole. Then we have the 1 circle here. And make sure you choose the circle for the size that you're cutting here at the collar. And then down here, we have the markings for the pocket placement for the robe. And what I have done is I've just gone ahead and pinned the 4 corners for the pocket marking. Now you can go ahead and do your pin tucks along the line, tailor tacks. You can do your tailor tacks along the line all the way around, but I'm only going to tack the four corners, and that will help me to place my pocket. If you're new to this and this is your first time, then I recommend maybe you should go ahead and do maybe four on each line. Okay, grab your thread, and I forgot to mention in the supplies needed that you're going to need a hand needle. So go ahead and thread your hand needle with a contrasting thread, double layer of thread. And what you're going to do is you can remove some of your pattern weights at this point. We're going to start with the circle at the armhole. So go ahead and insert your needle into that circle and then pull all the way through until you have about an inch or an inch and a half of tail left. Then you're going to come back up through the bottom, creating about a 1/8 inch seam. And then you're going to pull all the way through. Pull all the way through. Then you're going to go back in to the first hole, or as close as you can get, and pull through. And I'm going to place my thumb right here on top of the one thread. And we're going to pull through. And what I want to do is I want to create a loop, and my thumb I'm going to keep in between, and when the thread surrounds my thumb, that's the loop I want. And then I'm going to come back up through the bottom in the second hole again and pull all the way through. Okay? And then I'm going to go ahead and cut off the tail about an inch, inch and a half. And then finally, I'm going to cut open the loop. And that is your tailor tack. Now let's do another one. We're gonna go down here to the pocket, and I'm going to start on this corner here. So make sure you're choosing the correct line for the size that you're making. I'm making a small, so at the top of the line for small, I'm going to go down and pull through until I have about an inch, inch and a half of tail. I'm going to come right back up through, creating about a 1/8 inch stitch. And I think I said seam earlier. It's a stitch, not a seam. I'm going to go back down through the first hole. I'm going to hold this thread and create a loop around my thumb. And I'm going to come back up through the second hole from the bottom and pull all the way through. Okay, I'm going to take my scissors and cut off a tail, or leaving a tail about an inch, inch and a half, and then cut through the loop. And there I have a tailor's tack. So what you're going to do is either you can do the four corners like I'm going to do, or you can go through and put tailor's tacks along the line for the pocket or the size that you're going to cut. Our next step in completing the tailor's tack is you're going to go ahead and, if you're using pattern weights, you can remove all of your pattern weights. And make sure before doing this next step, I recommend that you do all of your tailor's tacks first, and then you can go back and do this step, which is cutting open the tacks so that you will have the markings on both layers of fabrics. Now, if you choose, you can do your tailor's tacks on single layers of fabric. For me, it's just quicker to do it double layer. So here's what we're going to do. And if you're going to do it single layer, you will need to cut out your fabric in single layers because you will need the pattern tissue to use to mark the tacks. So what we're going to do for the double layer is we're going to remove our pins and removing the pattern tissue first, you're going to slowly just pull the pattern tissue off of the fabric. Okay? And then you will remove that. And then we're going to take your small scissors or regular scissors if you're using them, and you're going to pull the two layers of fabric apart. Not fully, just a little bit. to expose your thread, and then you're going to cut center so that you have thread left on this side and thread left on that side. Of course, you have it on the top, and then you have just a tiny tack on the bottom. Okay, so again, you're going to pull the fabric layers apart until you have enough thread exposed to cut down the center. And there you have your tailor's tacks. Okay? And that's how we're going to mark our fabric if you're using a lofty, thicker fabric. Or if you're using a lightweight fabric, you can use tailor's tacks also. All right, now we're gonna get started sewing. I'll meet you at the sewing machine. Okay, if you have all of your pieces cut out and you've marked all of your pattern or fabric pieces, we're ready to sew. I want you to make sure you grab your pattern instruction sheet and keep it close by. I will follow along the instruction sheet, but I may go out of order, so you can keep yours close by so you can read along if you'd like. Now, I want you to grab pieces number two, your pocket pieces, you have two of them, and piece number four, which is the carrier for your belt on your robe. Set that one aside, grab one of your pocket pieces, and if you've used tailor tacks to mark your fold line, you're going to fold right along that fold line with, I'm looking at the wrong side of the fabric, so we're folding the right side onto the right side. If you've used tracing wheel and tracing paper, you're going to do the same thing. You're going to fold along that fold line, and then you're going to insert pins on both edges. Okay, so you're going to fold this, or pin that. All right, now if you are using a lightweight fabric, in the instructions, it has you to press over a quarter of an inch of a fold on the raw edge. So you can do that. Go ahead and press over 1/4 inch on your raw edge and then do this step. If you're using fleece, do not press. We are not going to be pressing fleece because it melts with heat. So throughout the entire project, you won't see me go to the ironing station because we will not be pressing. For those of you who are using another type of fabric that doesn't melt, then you go ahead and make sure you press your seams as you go. All right, so we have that sewn. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to sew in 1/4 inch. And again, I have a size 12 needle. My stitch length is at 3. And I'm doing a straight stitch, of course, and the stitch width is a 1. Or you could just wherever your stitch width should be straight, and your needle should be centered right in the center of your presser foot. So we're going to sew in 1/4 inch seam here. Back stitch. Same thing on the other side. You go ahead and clip away all of your threads. Now that we've sewn in sewn the edges together and you have that fold, you can go ahead and remove your threads from the tailor's tack. Or if you like, you can wait until you fold it over to move your thread, either way. And then we're going to fold this over. Actually, let's trim this off a little bit. We're going to trim the corner at a diagonal. And then on this one seam allowance, the short one, we're going to trim about half of that off. So diagonal, and then trim half of that off. All right, then we're going to turn it right side out. And using your point turner, if you have one, go ahead and push that corner out to square, or to a sharp point on both sides. Okay, and if you're new, a beginner, I would probably recommend leaving your pin tuck or your tailor tacks in before, or leave your tailor tacks in until after you turn it over so that you can still see that line there. Okay, we're gonna sew our sides, fold over and sew the sides down all the way around, and I'm going to sew in this direction. So I want to make sure that when I reach this corner that I'm not going to run into a problem of bumping into a raw edge and having this fabric to flip back over. So I'm going to show you what I do. So right here where we fold it, we're going to pin. And you can take your seam gauge to measure that, but I believe it's 3/8. Yes, it's about 3/8 of an inch. So just follow the natural fold of your fabric after you turn it right side out after stitching in the sides. Okay, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go down to the corner first. And I'm going to fold over. And I'm folding over about, almost a half of an inch from the point to the edge there. Okay, and then I'm going to insert a pin diagonally, right at the point. Okay, I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to fold in, and I'm going to insert a pin diagonally right at that point. All right, now let's go back over here where we started. So we're going to continue folding over and pinning all the way down. Now, before I fold over this edge, I'm going to fold up the bottom. And the reason I'm doing that is because when I fold up the bottom and then fold the side edge over the bottom, when I'm continuing to sew in this direction, I'm going to smoothly go over that, as opposed to if I folded in the side first and then folded the bottom up, as I sew, I'm going to bump into that raw edge. So go ahead and fold up your bottom first on this side, and then go ahead and insert a pin, and then go back and sew or fold over your side, and you're gonna get a nice even or nice neat mitered corner there. Okay, and then pin. Now we're gonna pin the bottom, continue pinning the bottom. And when we come over, let's insert one more pin. And when I come over to this side, I'm going to continue sewing in this direction. So I don't want to hit a raw corner again. So this time I'm going to fold in the side first so that my bottom folds over and I can continue sewing smoothly around that corner. So I'm folding over the side and pin. Then I'm going to fold over the bottom and get a nice neat mitered corner. Okay, and then we're going to just continue pinning all the way down, or all the way up to the top. Okay, now go in and insert the edges of the pin down into the fabric so that as you sew along and you're pulling those pins out, you won't stick yourself.
Okay, so make sure your fold is in, and we can just insert a pin there. Okay, now starting on this side, we're going to sew in close to the edge here, just to catch in that raw edge. It's about maybe a little less than 3/8 of an inch. It may be different with you depending on how much you fold it over. So back stitch. And just sew all the way down, making sure you're catching in that edge. Get to the bottom, I'm going to remove this corner piece or pin and sew down. And then I'm going to lift my presser foot, I'm going to pivot to the right, and then press it back down and continue sewing. And then the last stitch we're going to do on the pocket is a row of stitching on the top edge of the pocket. So remove that pin if you inserted it. And then we're just going to sew from one end to the other end. And just make sure you feel where the edge is so you're catching it in. So place that in. And I'm going to insert mine at the 3/4 inch mark and backstitch. Using a lightweight fabric, then you can go ahead and press your pocket piece nice and flat. If you're using fleece or any type of lofty fabric, don't press because it will melt. At least with fleece, it will melt. So go ahead and take care of both pocket pieces and then meet me back here. We're going to do our carrier, the belt carrier. And for this, you're going to take the right side of your fabric, the wrong side of your fabric, and you're going to fold it in half like this, okay? And for those of us using fleece, we're going to finger press it because we're not going to take it to the ironing station. If you're using lightweight fabric, go ahead and press it in half, okay? And then what you're going to do is you're going to take your raw edge and fold it into that fold. Fold it in half again to where your fold is, okay, all the way down. Take the raw edge and fold it into the fold. Okay. We're gonna turn it over and do the same thing on the other side. Fold this side halfway in to that first fold, all right? And what we're doing is we're making sure that these edges are even when we fold it in, all right? So as we go, we can pin to keep that in place while we continue folding the rest, all right? So fold it in and continue pinning all the way down, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine. Now that we have our carrier all pinned together, we're gonna go ahead and insert two rows of stitching. The first row is going to be right along the edge here with the two folds. We're gonna stitch right along the edge, and then the second row will be on the other edge. Okay, so go ahead and insert your carrier to where you're sewing right on the edge. And then we're going to insert a row of stitching. Back stitch. Stitching, and then you're going to go and do the same thing on the opposite side, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine. Okay, so we've basted it on the carrier there. Okay, now go ahead and do the same thing on the opposite side and meet me back here at the machine. Okay, we're going to attach our pocket pieces to the front of a robe. So with your front piece of the robe facing right side up, you're gonna take your pocket and you're gonna line up the corners with the corners of the tailor tacks. Or if you did a complete line of tailor tacks, then you can line it up with your outline. Okay, so go ahead and line up the corners with the top tacks, and then the bottoms with the bottom tacks. And then we're just going to pin those in place, or we're going to pin the pocket in place. All the way around. And use as many pins as you feel is necessary for your comfort. And then we're going to insert a row of stitching right along the edge of your pocket, all the way around, beginning and ending with a back stitch. So let's place our fabric right along the edge. And again, insert those pins so that you don't stick yourself as you go along. And backstitch. Pivot. can go and remove your tailor tacks, and there you have your pocket sewn on. So go ahead and do that with both front pieces, and then grab your back piece and your carrier, and then meet me back here at the sewing machine. Okay, take piece number four, your carrier that we've already sewn together, and you're going to fold it in half, and then you're just going to cut it in half. Right. Now take one piece, and here we have our back piece. We're going to open it out to where the right side is showing. We're going to take one carrier, fold it in half, and we're going to place it right on top of the marking here, this tailor tack, or if you're using a lighter fabric, it's your the mark you trace with your tracing wheel. And we're going to pin that in place. Now you will notice I did not pin my carrier one on top of the other like this. And for me personally, I don't do that because it creates a really large bump to sew over. So I kind of off center mine, or placed them like side by side, not completely side by side like this, but just overlapping a little bit so I don't have as big a hump to go over. And then when you turn it over, your belt loop is going to go through there and it's just fine. So you can do it this way, or if you choose, you can go one on top of the other. Just be ready to sew over a larger hump. Okay, so you're going to sew or pin that, and you'll do the same thing on the other side. Then we're going to place that at the 5/8 inch seam line. And we're going to baste the carrier onto the row. So set up your machine for a basting stitch. That is the longest stitch on your machine. And we're going to just baste it in place. Okay, we're looking at our two front pieces, and I have the right sides facing up. What we're going to do next is we're going to attach the top collar and insert a center seam, and this is the back edge of the collar for the robe. So take the two front pieces, and you're going to line it up with the right sides facing and pin those together. And we're going to insert a row of stitching 5/8 of an inch. Make sure you change back to your straight stitch or your regular stitch. I'm sewing at a 3 for my length since I'm sewing fleece. Okay, 5/8 inch seam. We're going to back stitch and stitch all the way to the end. Open that up with the wrong side facing up so that we can see the seam allowances, and we're going to finger press that open. If you're sewing with a lightweight fabric, you can press it with your iron. Okay, so we're going to steam press that, or finger press it with the fleece. Now the next thing we're going to do is, if you are using serger to finish off your seams, you can go ahead and do that right now. Or if you're using pinking shears, you can go ahead and trim that. Remember, I said I'm going to use a double needle to finish mine. So I'm going to go ahead and set my machine up to finish this off with a double needle. so that I can have stitching on both sides of my seam here. And then we're going to come back and insert some stitching around the collar edge. So I'll meet you back here in a second. I'm going to set my machine up for the double needle. Okay, I have inserted my double needle on the machine. I have added a second spool of thread and just threaded it the same way I threaded the first spool and threaded into the double needle. So now I'm going to insert the fabric along the seam that I just sewed with the right side facing up. And I'm going to place my fabric into the machine where that center seam is at the center of my presser foot. And the two needles are going to sew seams on both sides of that seam. Or sew seams, yes, on both sides of that existing seam. And I'm just going to sew all the way down to the bottom. Neat, pretty double stitch. And then I will turn it over and you will see it creates a zigzag stitch right along that seam on the wrong side. And then I will go in and just trim away the extra fabric. And if you're using a double needle, you can use a pinking shears if you like. I'm just going to go ahead and use my regular shears and trim it away very close to the stitching. And I don't have to worry about raveling because this is fleece. It does not ravel. And there you have it, the inside and the outside. So this is the method I will be using for the rest of my robe when I finish my seams. You feel free to use whichever finishing method you would like. Okay, so we have this. Now the next step is we're going to insert a row of stitching along the collar. This is the wrong side, okay? Now, we're going to insert our fabric with the right side up, okay? And at the 5/8 inch mark seam line, we're gonna go ahead and insert a row of stitching all the way around, okay? But before we insert that row of stitching, we need to change from the double needle back to a single needle. So I'm gonna change my needle and meet you guys back here at the machine. Okay, let's begin. And we're going to sew all the way down to this tailor's tack. Lift your presser foot and pivot. And that's going to put you, it should put you right at the 5/8 inch mark when you pivot. Make sure that your seams are flat if you did not trim away, or your seam allowance is flat when you sew over. Again, sew over to the tailor tack. or the mark that you made on your fabric. Pivot. And you don't need to backstitch with this row of stitching. Don't know why I did that. Now, the next step is you're going to clip into the corners. You have two corners, this corner and that corner. You want to take your scissors and you want to clip right up to that stitching without cutting through the threads. Okay. Cut right up to that stitching in the corner. Okay. Next, we're going to attach the back piece to the front piece at the neck and shoulder edge. So grab your back piece, and first we're going to insert a row of stay stitching at the back neck edge. So starting from one edge, we're going to stitch from the edge to the center, and then we're going to go to the other edge and stitch to the center. All right, so at half an inch seam line, go ahead and stitch to the center. Then we're going to do the same thing from the other edge. Place our back piece in front of us with the right side facing up, and then grab your front piece and we're going to place the front piece, the neck edge, right along the neck edge of the back piece with the right sides facing. So we're going to start pinning where our notches are. So let's go ahead and pin the notches on the shoulder on both sides. Okay, and then we're going to pin the notches right here at the neck edge. Line those up. Okay, you can pin your ends also, the end, the shoulder, the edge of the fabric, where your shoulders are. Now, this piece takes a little extra attention. You have your marking here, and you have your marking here, where we clipped up to the corner. These two you need to line up. So line up those markings, your pin tucks. All right. And then we're going to take the neck, this pattern piece we've pinned right there where the tailor's tack is. We're going to take this front and we're going to turn it to line it up right along the edge to where it's even. Use however many pins you need, okay? Same thing on the other side. Take the tailor tack markings and pin them. You will notice this V is across from this point here, okay? I'm going to pin that. And then go straight across at the shoulder. making sure you don't have folds in there, all right? And just make sure you get that all even across the back neck edge, okay? And there we have it. Now, let's sew this in one continuous seam. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna sew from the edge to this corner, then we're going to pivot, turning the fabric, sew across, pivot again, and sew all the way to the other end. Okay, so let's go ahead and insert your fabric at the 5/8 inch mark, 5/8 inch seam line. And stick those pins in if you need to, so you don't stick yourself along the way. And let's begin stitching. Back stitch. Now we're coming up on that pin tuck, that corner. Alrighty. Now, when you get here, make sure you're not sewing any folds in. So kind of flatten that out with your finger. And go right to that pin tuck, to that marking. Okay. Right when you get to that corner where the tailor's tack is, that's where you're going to lift and you're going to pivot your fabric in the to the right, making sure all this extra fabric on top is out of the way. Press your foot down and continue. Sure that your edges are even. And we're coming up on the other tailor's tack. I'm going to move that pin, making sure that everything is flat underneath and I'm not sewing in any folds. When you reach that point, lift your presser foot and pivot, making sure you don't have any folds on the bottom or the top. And continue sewing all the way to the end. To go in and clip here and along the back neck edge. Okay, we're just going to clip just up to the stitching. And I'm going to use those previous notches. And what I'm going to do is, again, I'm using fleece. I'm going to go ahead and finish my seam allowances with a double needle. You go ahead and finish yours however you choose. And for the center back neck edge, you want to, if you're using a lightweight fabric, you want to finish it and press it toward the collar, not toward the back, but toward the front collar. All right? So go ahead and finish that off, and I'll meet you back here at the sewing machine.